Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. Karibuni sana you guys. I know it's been a minute, nimewa miss. I'm happy to be back, you guys. So, you guys, even before I start, I just want to say it's very unfortunate what's going on all over the world, you guys. This corona pandemic is just crazy. I'm just hoping everybody's just keeping safe. You're staying indoors, you know, sanitizing, keeping clean, you know, just stay safe, you guys, because we're just hoping this thing ends. Just stay safe, you guys. I'm also trying to stay safe with my family, you guys. But yeah, the last time I filmed, I was heavily pregnant. Now I am not pregnant. My tummy is all gone. My baby is here, guys. And I cannot explain or express how excited and happy I am because my baby's here. It's such a blessing, you guys. Wow. Anyway, let's get to the video before I start getting all emotional. But I'm glad to be back. Hi, you guys, I have new subscribers. Thank you for subscribing to my channel, the newbies. Thank you. Welcome to the Stephy Panthers. Wow, I am so excited. Our family is growing and growing slowly by slowly. Thank you so much. Yes. So you guys, about my delivery and my labor and delivery now. Let's get to the video. You guys, first of all, hey, I thought, honestly, to be honest with you guys, I was surrounded by people who were like, hey, you will have an easy, like, your labor and delivery will be so easy, you know, because where, you know, you, I don't know why people are just telling me it's gonna be, I don't know why I was surrounded by people who are telling me it's gonna be easy. I think they were telling me what I wanted to hear. And I don't know. So I had this thought that, especially because, you guys, they say that when you have crazy periods, your giving birth process won't be as crazy. So I thought, because me, I get bad cramps, I get bad, my periods are just so crazy. So I thought, they will not labor for long. Why? You guys, so let me just tell you how it really happened. I had to go back home, first of all, because my guy he goes for night shift, sometimes at for day shift, so he's never like gone during the day, and at night he's here, sometimes at night he's not here, and you know the baby might come at night, and baby being alone is not so advisable and all that. So we decided I will go back home, my mom will take care of me, because there's always somebody at home, whether it's at night, whether it's during the day, there's always someone at home. So we were sure that I would be taken care of, I would be okay, you know, in case it happens, I will have somebody there. So I went back home the last week of February, because my due date was on 7th March. So the last week of February, I went back home, just, you know, because it's unpredictable, the baby might come earlier, the baby might come late, so we never know, you never know the time, but you have to prepare. So I just went back home and chilled and just waited. Then, but I was so big, I was so heavy, I was so tired. So we were sure it would happen that last week of February or the first few days of March. But my due date was on 7th. So I was so sure before 7th, I would get the baby. Yeah, so I thought. But the week went on and I didn't get the baby. The last week of February went by, I didn't get the baby. The first week of March came. So on 7th, that is Saturday, the first Saturday of March, my mom came home from work and she was like, oh, let's go for a walk, because I stayed indoors throughout. I just never left the house because I was always tired, so lazy, you know, the last days are just crazy. So I was like, let me just, also my mom was like, let's get out, let's take some fresh air in, let's take a walk, you know, and just, you know, change the scenery. So we went for a walk, you guys. It was a bit long. So on our way back home, you guys, I started cramping like crazy. That's Saturday evening. I started cramping like crazy, like it was intense. So my mom was like, maybe I have to fix you sick, like we're not even going to sleep. I'm so sure if I pick up point, we'll just have to go to hospital. So I was like, hey, because we miss her so much, we want her here. I was like, sour. We got home, I chill, relaxed. The pain was on and off, but it was not consistent. But when it came, it was intense. But it was not consistent. So, and you know, labor is consistent. So we have to wait for it to be consistent. So we slept. You guys, that night, I did not sleep vizuri, because I would sleep and then the pain would come. I would wake up. I would eat. It was so painful, you guys. I would wake up and then go back to sleep. The pain would come again. And it was just so crazy. It was crazy. But by morning, we were so sure now we need to go to hospital because now the pain is intense. And every time I got some pain, my mom would come to the room and she would be like, hang in there, you know, because it was crazy. I didn't even scream, but there's a way I would sound like, you know, that's kind of, when you're in pain, there's a way you sound, right? I would sound like that. And she would come running and she'd be like, hey, the pain is back. And it is, you know, she would sympathize with me. But they were still not consistent. But in the morning, because the pain was there throughout the night, we were like, hey, let's just go to hospital because the pain was just crazy. So we went to hospital. I was tested. You guys, I was just 2 centimeters. My cervix was open 2 centimeters. And they admit at 3 centimeters. I was still in the inactive phase of labor. So I couldn't be admitted. But the doctor was like, you do this, walk around for like 3-4 hours, then come back, we test you. If you get to 3 centimeters, we will admit you. That will mean now you're heading to the active phase. But he gave me a disclaimer. Just know that to get to 3 centimeters may take 1 hour, 2 hours, like 4 hours. It may take 1 day, 2 days, 3 days, even a week. So it's to get from the inactive phase to the active phase might take, you know, long. It may take long. So, but the walking would speed up. So I walked around, you guys, because we got that around 11, 12. I walked around till around 3. So I went back at 3. I was tested. I was still at 2 centimeters. Nothing changed. And then I walked, you guys, I walked like a mad woman because I wanted, like, let's get admitted. Let's do this. Let's finish this and let's have this baby. But it did not work out. So we had to go back home. We had to go back home, but mind you, the pain was still coming back on and off, on and off, on and off. But when I got home, that's now, because now we are in Sunday, right? Because now that's Sunday morning, we went to check to be checked and all that. So that Sunday evening, we went back home, chilled. But now Sunday night, that night, wait. I thought Sunday I was in pain, you guys. Sunday night was crazy. Like I couldn't even lie down for long. I was in so much pain, and it would. Guy, the pain would come, eh? I would feel so much pain, you guys. And then, you know, the doctor was like, even don't worry, just go home. The time the pain comes, you will, anyway, you know, because there's that pain that comes, and you're like, hey, it is time. So, and then now, as time went by throughout the night, the pain, the intervals got closer and closer. So that meant something was actually happening. Now I'm actually getting to the active phase, probably. That's then we did not know. So on Monday morning, we're like, hey, let's go back to hospital. We didn't, okay. And on Sunday, that Sunday morning stuff that we went to hospital, my guy came for us, that he picked us up and took us to hospital. But on Monday morning, we didn't even wait. That's how intense the pain was. We just went straight to hospital, and that we were like, well, ukitoka job, just come find us there, because the pain was just crazy. We could not wait for nobody. So we went, and I was tested again. I was at 3 centimeters, so I was admitted. I was admitted at 2, because we got there around 11, 12 still. And we were admitted by 2. I was admitted, but the docs were like, if you want to speed this process up, just walk. Walk, sister, walk. That's Monday. Is that Monday Chana, you know? So I had something to eat, then I started walking, you guys. I would walk, but you know now the pain is intense. I would walk. Pain and ilemea. It was just intense. It was crazy, but I was so determined. I just wanted, like, let this come. You know, the more you walk, you speed up the labor. The more the labor comes, the more you open up. The labor pains come, the more you open up. See, I was so determined to bring this, you know, this bring this whole process to a closure. So I walked in so much pain. I walked, you guys. Then, you know, they test after every 3 to 4 hours. So they kept testing. I would, like, from 3 centimeters at around 6, I was tested. I was at 4 centimeters around 10:30. There I was tested. I was at 5 centimeters, like that. At 2. Now at 2, you guys, but it got to 2 a.m. That's now we are at what we have VUCA'd from Monday to Tuesday morning. Now at 2 a.m. on Tuesday, the doctors are like, hey, you know, now I'm in so much pain. I've labored for quite some time already. I'm in so much pain, and nafunguka pole pole. Then they're like, let's speed this process up to make sure you're not hurting too much, and you know, just to speed the process up, let's just induce you. So I was given the first induction, you know, that kachupa they give you, they insert and all that. And you guys, induction is crazy. When you hear induction, you know it is severe pain. You know, I was feeling pain, but now I am feeling severe pain. Like, oh, you guys. So what happened? Where I started, like, sasa pain was coming, and then the intervals were so close, so there's no time to, like, ati do what? Hey, me, I couldn't even walk. I had to go outside the way I was walking, because now I have that there's a stand, and there's, I don't know what to call it, but now the induction is there, and it's entering pole pole, and the pain is intense. I could not move far, and then, you know, the pain is crazy, and it was just crazy, you guys. And then the doctor was like, don't worry, you'll just receive a few droplets, and then you'll open up completely, and here's the baby. So at around, I think, 4 or 5, they came back and tested me, you guys. I was at 7 centimeters. Yes, I was at 7 centimeters. So it was actually working. So we went, the further the drip got in, oh, it's called a drip. The further the drip got in, the induction drip, the more the pain got intense, you guys. I was sweating like crazy. I was holding my guy and my mom beside. I was just, because I was with both of them throughout the night. Like, they were there through the whole labor process, but my guy had to leave for some time, then he came back. But the pain was crazy, like, And then, you guys, so something funny, once I think the bottle was half, I think around 6 a.m. they came again. At around 5, they came again. The time they tested, the bottle was in the kuisha. Like, I had, like, finished the whole thing. You know, guys just do a quarter and they go and give birth. Me, I had finished the whole thing. I was still not opening up. And then, when I was tested, you know, they use fingers, right? That's why I'm doing this. When they tested again, you guys, I was at 8 centimeters. Like, any a whole bottle in the lisonga from 6 to 8 centimeters. So, and you know, it's supposed to, like, tow you from, like, 3 to 10 real quick. You know, nikona songa pole pole. So the doc is like, let's give you another one. Another one, you guys. Another one means more pain. So, you guys, I was given another one. The pain was crazy. Now there I was like, I'm in Asia. Like, it was too much, you guys. But I was given another, you know, the drip was brought in to supposed to help me open up. And then when they say, before the second one was broke, actually I forgot to say, my water did not break, nilitobolewa, to speed up the process. Everything I'm being done for is to speed up the process. And I'm in so much pain, don't forget. But the first bottle is over, we're in the second bottle, nabado sifunguki vizuri, like, I'm not getting to 10 centimeters, I'm just there at 8 centimeters. So, but when the second one was brought, they were checking, like, they were not waiting for 3 hours, it was just come like an hour, they would come back an hour, and I was still at 8, I was not moving from 6, 7, 8, it's Tuesday now, from 6 a.m, 7 a.m, 8 a.m, 9 a.m, 10 a.m, I was still at 8 centimeters, you guys, until the doc was like, "Weh, now this is now apana, you ufunguki," because I'm supposed to get to certain centimeters, otherwise when I give birth at 8, I would get hurt and all that. So I had to wait, and now the pain was getting crazy. I remember there's a point I told my mom, me, enough is enough. I cannot anymore. Because now, you know, it figures a point, the baby is pushing you. You feel like you're going to poop, but it's not poop. It's actually the baby who is pushing. And then, you know, there's a point you can hold, and the pushing is coming. And the pushing happens when you're getting the contractions. The pain is intense. The baby wants to, you know, now the baby wants to come out. You know, you're trying to hold in as it, okay, usiumie. But it's still crazy because I could feel I'm getting weaker and weaker by the minute. I could feel like I'm giving in, like, it's too much, I can't. But the doctors kept telling me, don't push, you'll hurt the baby, don't push. Now that fact that I was told that I'm going to hurt the baby was just giving me a little strength. But you guys, I was in so much pain. And then the baby was pressing, like, on me, Kamisa. I was, no, that's another kind of pain. You guys, it was just so intense. Then it figured a point, I was like, me, I cannot. I told my mom, me, I can't anymore. It's too painful. I am giving up. I remember telling my mom, siwezi anymore. Like, enough. I even yelled and called the doctor. Like, I can't. The baby is pushing me. She wants to come out. I cannot hold it anymore. So the dog's coming. The dog comes in. And I mind you, I've shouted like a madwoman. Because I was in so much pain. Okay, I cannot believe I'm laughing right now. Because then I was... Hey, anyway. So the dog comes in and is like, let's go to my office. Let's go to my the labor room. So me was like, hey, it's time. Come with the doctor, I'm scared. Finally, my please is like, let's go have this baby. So we go, we get to the that's around 10, 11. Now we are at 11 a.m. now. We are at 11 a.m. So the doctor is like, let me see how far. Maybe we should attend. I had to, as in now it's time to go. Like, so he pimas me, you guys, I'm still at 18, and she's songy. I feel like crying, kabisa, I'm not songing. Then he's like, you lie here, I am coming back. So, me was like, probably he's like, maybe now we have to now do at 8 centimeters, because now we can't wait anymore. I said to Kazai, at 8 centimeters, we get over with this, because I'm a owner, I am suffering. Everyone could see, even any you guys, people would come, when I labor, when I'm also, when I'm there, when I'm at 12, and I'm scared, people go to one. They come back, they recover. Yeah, I'm just there waiting for my baby. Like, it was intense. People, I would bond there with people, they would go give birth, go, any to go to the wards, and I'm just there waiting for mine. My MC for Mookie. Anyway, so I chilled there waiting for the doc. The doc went out for quite some time. And remember when I was like, any of you guys, I had not slept well on Saturday, I had not slept well on Sunday. This is now Monday night. Sijalavi zuri. I was so sleepy, in so much pain. You know, so I was so weak. So I laid there. I was like, Kai Aki God, don't let me die. Don't let my baby die. And Ushaifika, a point you're like, I am seeing me dying. You know, I even told God, if I'm not going to make it, please do not let my baby, and do not let my baby die. Let her make it. If I won't make it, let her make it. Like, I had figured at that point, I was like, don't let my baby die. You know, let her survive. You know, it is going in vain because I had labored for so long. I was in some, I was feeling my body giving up. She's scared, like your body is giving up because I was so weak. I was so tired. That pain, bado iko. The pain was still intense. The pain was still driving me crazy. So I sat there. I remember I was my eyes were getting weak. I was trying to fall asleep, but the pain would come. You know, the contractions are on and off, so when they would go away, I'd sleep. It would go then, but now see for like 2 seconds, then the pain would come back, and then the pain would, you know, finish me. I would hold the tail. I remember I would hold that carpet because I was laying on that bed. I could deliver. I would hold it so tightly. Then I was told to breathe, you guys. I tried breathing at this point. Me the kind of shinda, because before I was trying to save my energy and all that instead of screaming. But now here time, I could not breathe. I just wanted this whole process to be over, you guys. So anyway, I just lay there helplessly waiting for the doc to tell me the next step, because me, I was just there. The pain was shaped skill chung was scared. Now enough is enough. I need for. Anyway, so I lay there. Then in like the next 10 minutes, the dog comes back. And then the dog doesn't come back alone. He comes back with this other doctor and my mom. And then he's like, you know what? We need to rush you to theater. You guys, hearing that, you know, mini Lizuba. Like, I just gazed and she zoned out. Like, I just zoned out. I was like, theater? Why theater? Like, am I, you know, I was like, you know, before he came in, I was like, I'm going to die, right? So now he mentions theater, he's like, he's confirming, like, I might die. I'm like, now this is now, you know, I hear you guys, I was so scared, I became numb. I remember he talked, I zoned out. None of the you hear in the movies, like, somebody zones out and a scared voice says in the back, I would feel that. I was like, are you serious? Then this other doctor is like, I'm the surgeon. I'm the one who's going to be in charge of anesthesia. You need to sign here. You know what? Where? So I signed. You guys, I didn't even read. I just signed. And then, okay, you guys, I was so scared. There was like, something is wrong with me. Then he tried to explain that my cervix has this condition that, you know, there are those, you know, first of all, my baby is big. Right, my baby is big, not this normal kind, not underweight, not this normal kind of weight. She's big, and then my cervix is not open. It's not open enough. So if I push at 8 centimeters, because if we look any further, depending, I'm not going to open up anytime soon. So and the baby is big. So if I push, the baby would be hurt. The head would be hurt, and you know that leads to abnormalities. It would really affect the baby in so many ways. And I would also tear real bad, real, real bad. And they would have to cut. It's crazy. So me and the baby would be hurt, and it's very risky to push at 8 centimeters with this kind of the size of my baby. It's very risky. So he was like, we need to rush you to the theater. So I signed, and it happened so fast. I signed. The next minute I see other nurses coming in with dressed, you know, those actors at theater in boots and all that. He's like, they take me to the dressing room. I'm dressed. And it happened so fast. I'm dressed, and then the next minute I'm in the theater. I'm being, you know, and then you guys, and it's so funny. I was in so much pain, but I was so confused. Like, I was so confused. I was just there. I was just looking at people. I was just like, hey, this is happening. I was like, this is happening. This is really happening. You know, I was like, am I in a movie? Am I dreaming? Is this really happening? Like, anyway, so we got to the theater, and mind you, I'm still in pain. I remember that anesthesia guy wanted to prick, you know. Now, okay, then I remember. I was like, you guys, are you going to do me full? Are you going to put the anesthesia my whole body, or am I going to do the epidural? That like a half thing. And then they kept telling me we're going to do half because it's safer, it's convenient. They gave me benefits. I can't even remember, but I was just like, I kept asking, are we going to do full? Are we going to do half? I was just so confused, you guys. But that surgeon, the main surgeon, came in and explained everything, and then I was injected, you guys. I thought I would feel pain. I thought people say that injection is pain because, you know, it's unadunga kwa backbone, but at the lower back here. But you guys, me, I had felt pain. I think I became numb, or I don't know, because I didn't feel it. I remember, but the pain I felt was the labor, because I was still laboring even in the theater. Then the pain would still come back. So I was like, by the way, listen, I'm to anesthesia before I do, because you know you have to stay still. Then I have to stay like this so that you can be able to prick me. But you guys, when the labor pains would come, I would be like, I would just chill. I would just wait this pain to go, and only do, because me, I could not stand still. And you know, he needs me still for the injections. But when the pain comes, I cannot stand still. The pain was so crazy. But finally he injected me, the pain went away. You know, when the anesthesia kicks in, there's no more pain. The pain went away, but I was still so scared. Will I make it? What if it goes wrong? You know, what if my baby is not talking? What if my baby's not there and they're not telling me? You know, I had so many questions, I had so many thoughts. But before the whole procedure was started, the main surgeon, she prayed. Okay, you guys. Me, once she prayed, that was it. I was like, ah, God is here. Like, I felt some kind of relief. I can't even explain. I think she knows how to get out the attention. Because me, she prayed, and I felt safe. I felt like God is in control. I felt like I'm not alone. And they started the process. I could feel my body. I wasn't feeling any pain, but I could feel my organs move and all that. And before I knew it, my baby was crying. I heard her cry. It was so amazing, you guys. I heard her cry, and then they got her out. And, you know, me lying down, they said I was lying down. They were cleaning her just there. So I could see the whole process. I saw them cleaning her, weighing her, you know, giving her, you know, just taking care of her. I saw everything, and it was so magical. She was big, you guys. I got her at 4.1. She was big. She was beautiful. Okay. And then immediately, like they say, I know it's so cliche, but immediately, you know, I even forgot the pain. Okay. I know it's so cliche, but imagine I forgot the pain. And we went to recovery. She was dressed, and she was brought to me. You know, they came out so hungry. Especially, she was so hungry. Anyway, so she, you know, now after C-section, you're not able to move. Especially, you're not able to move for 6 hours. My lower abdomen, that is, because I was, so I wasn't able to move for 6 hours. So what happened? The nurse came. I was taken to another bed, obviously, to the recovery room and whatever. So the baby was brought and was aliyekeleka bubiangu because I couldn't hold her and feed her because I couldn't move. So that she was latched on me. However, you guys, that it was not done properly because, you know, I'm the only one who can do it properly because I know this position is good for me. The whole nipple is here. You know, now, kakinyonya kama nime lay down, it's not comfortable. So, you guys, she didn't latch properly. So, my nipple cracked. Wait. That is another story. You guys, then the few days I was there, I was in so much pain. She would feel, I would scream. We went home. It got worse. Kai. She would feed, I would, hey, it was crazy, but I got something for that. Now I'm not in pain when she feeds. We enjoy, we stare at each other, smile at each other. It's amazing, it's magical. So anyway, after recovery, I was taken to the ward, and you know, I healed there. You know, they have to observe us for a few days. I think I stayed for 3 days because I got her on the 10th, that Tuesday at 12:22, and we left on Thursday at 2. So yeah, and we went home and we have been growing ever since. I'm still recovering, although my scar got some infection kidogo, but I got medicine for that. I'm still recovering, you guys. My baby is so cute, she's so adorable, you guys. When she was born, she looked so much like the dad. She still looks so much like the dad. Like, I'm even jealous, but people are saying some bits of me are being thin. Me, I think I took her to light skin. Okay, maybe me see light skin, don't get it twisted, but at least she took my slightly light complexion. She's not as dark, but that's it. And probably my nails, she has my nails and my hand, her hands is angled. Lakini, the face, the eyes, we're not sure who she looks like, but mostly she looks like the dad. She looks like the dad, you guys. But anyway, we're just so happy. We're just so happy with this blessing we got. It's just such a blessing to have her around. We're growing together, we're learning together. It's just been an amazing experience, and I'm so grateful to God that I did not die. The baby did not die. We both came out healthy and okay, and we are fine. I did not take it for granted, because there's a lady who went after me. The baby did not make it, and that got to me, you guys. No, not every day you go to hospital to have a baby, you come out with a baby. Not all the time, but God has been faithful. We did. And I'm not taking it for granted. My parting shot, you guys. I have to say this. Women, mothers are not underrated. Mothers are not, I think they are not given enough credit. It is not a joke what a mother goes through to have a baby. Mimi experience first time. Aki, that baby, it is always so annoying. Aki, ananiam shianga mtoto. Aki, hate that motorbike. Anyway, you guys, I respect every mother out there. Every mother out there. Every person who has ever given birth, even if the baby did not make it or not, or made it, I respect every mother out there. Okay. It is not a joke. And I just thank God for this opportunity to be a mom to this beautiful angel. Yes, I'm just so grateful for the support I've been getting from my family. And, you know, my mom has been there for me, from day one, but she was like, she never wants to go through that again, because it's not easy to watch your baby like suffer. It was hard. I labored for so long, and then I ended up going to the theater. But I'm just grateful everything worked out. This video is now so long. I am so sorry, but I'm just glad I am, you know, where I am right now with my baby. You know, it's such a blessing. Just the experience has been amazing. Just being there for her. She's now a month, and she's almost 2 months actually. She was born on the 10th of March. Guys, she's so adorable. She's so fat. Like, she's so cute and healthy. She's a crazy feeder. Like, she feeds a lot. I'm scared that only. I can hear she's in the bedroom with the dad. Anyway, let me finish this. You guys, thank you for watching this video. I just wanted to put this here just to remember this experience. And I'm not just saying this a how, but I just want to just pin it here. And I want to encourage every mother out there who's about to go give birth. Don't worry. God will see you through. God will only see through. My situation was crazy, but he saw me through, and he will see you through as well. And guys, thank you for supporting this sister. Me, I'm just loving the support that you guys are giving me. Thank you for 173 subscribers. You want to win with 173. Yay! Guys, see you in my next video. Guys, thank you so much for watching. See you in my next video. Bye.